This is the SAP Developer News for September 19th, 2024.
Hello, SAP community. The much-awaited Devtoberfest 2024 is here, running from September 23rd to October 25th. Devtoberfest helps to prepare for SAP TechEd and offers a mix of educational sessions, hands-on developer tools, and fun activities like Petoberfest, Techtoberfest, and Spooktoberfest. It is a point-based contest, and the Devtoberfest animated contest game board is already live. You can earn points by attending sessions, completing developer tutorials linked to weekly topics, or engaging in activities that benefit the SAP developer community. The grand prize is a retreat at an SAP TechEd Roadshow stop in 2025. Exciting, right? To start participating, join the Devtoberfest group after reviewing the legal terms and conditions posted there. We will kickstart Devtoberfest on Monday, September 23rd, which is the ABAP Cap Day. Week 1, we are bringing to you many exciting sessions in ABAP, mainly on clean core extensibility, building partner products on SAP BTP, major updates in embedded analytics, and data integration in ABAP Cloud with SQL services and CDS external entities. Week 1 also covers an exciting session on CAP, It's Time to TypeScript CAP Edition. On Tooling Tuesdays, we'll focus on SAP Build Process Automation, Build Code, and Build Apps. Integration Wednesdays will have sessions on Flashpipe, CPI Helper, and CPI Lint. Math Thursdays will focus on Machine Learning, AI, and Data with sessions on SAP Generative AI Hub, SAP Data Sphere, etc. Frontend Fridays will have sessions on UI5 Freestyle and SAP Fiori tools. Don't forget to participate in the Fun Friday event Petoberfest by clicking pictures with your pets at your workstation. So join us in this fun ride of learning and enjoy.
Good morning. The latest release of CAP, August 2024, in fact, is out. And with it, there are improvements and fixes to the latest major release 8, which came out earlier this year, in the form of CAP Node.js 8.2.1 and CAP Java 3.2.0. Let me take this opportunity on my walk this morning to go through some of those highlights. So, first up, when the latest major release of CAP came out earlier this year, the new database services went GA, including the database service for SAP HANA. One of the benefits of this new database service for the Node.js runtime is that HANA native associations were no longer required to represent associations at the CDS level. This was great, mostly because it brought longer deploy times when we used SAP HANA native associations. Plus, there was the chance of indirect dependencies also being created. And if you're wondering about the Java runtime, the Java runtime hasn't used native SAP HANA associations for a while. Anyway, at the time, the release notes advised us to switch off the HANA native associations using configuration. With this August 2024 release, that switch is now automatic. When you start a new project and do, for example, CDS add HANA, you get a switch in the configuration that turns these native associations off by default. In the area of the CDS language and compiler, you can now use CDS deploy --script to generate a SQL script as a starting point for manual schema migration. Note that in contrast to the existing --dry option, it accepts and produces DDL statements that could lead to data loss. So are A, not supported for automatic schema migration, and B, contains relevant warnings in the right places. In the Node.js runtime, there are also some important changes, one of which is that linked definitions, the class that is used to represent internally structures of services and more, now no longer have the convenience methods such as for each, map, filter, and so on that you would normally expect to have to process the linked definitions as arrays. Because basically, linked definitions are not arrays. They're more than that. So these methods have been removed. In my opinion, this is great because it reminds us that we have to treat the data as it is. And so one thing to do is maybe convert the data to arrays using the rest parameter inside, for example, an array, a literal array constructor. Another improvement is that you can now programmatically, i.e. dynamically at runtime, control and activate the CDS debug output at runtime. This means you can turn on debug for cat modules as you go. In the Java runtime, there's now beta level support for recursive hierarchies with OData v4 in SAP HANA. Recursive hierarchy is an experimental term in the OData hierarchy vocabulary and is used, for example, with SAP Fiori tree tables. You can also now define the name of the Java interfaces generated for CDS entities and structured types using a new annotation. In the multi-tenancy area, activating extensions using the SAP Extensibility Service can now be done asynchronously. You achieve this by sending a prefer header in the HTTP request with the value of respond async. This, in my opinion, is a really neat way of coordinating this using the RFC 7240 standard authored by an old acquaintance of mine. Well, I'm almost home, but there's just time to tell you about improvements in the tools area. So first, for all you IntelliJ users out there, the SAP CDS language support plugin is now available on the JetBrains marketplace, which means it's directly installable now. Great. For all you TypeScript users, there's a new CLI command CDS TSX, which in contrast to the existing CDS TS command uses a different, faster engine. This feature is in beta still at the moment. So I'm back home. There's one more thing to tell you about, and that is if you want to use the SAP Cloud Logging Service instead of the SAP Application Logging Service, you can do that. And there's an option to use telemetry as well, including an option to use Dynatrace. What's not to like? Anyway, that's it for this August 2024 release. See you next time.
Hello, everybody. I'm at Tbilisi, Georgia, with Daniel at EPAM office doing SAP Build and Cap Code Jam. It's really great to be here.
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun. And because it's only a couple of days before Devtoberfest, we wanted to tell you something about the contest. So the contest, you can earn enough points to get a trip to TechEd perhaps next year. And one of the ways to get points is by doing the traditional SAP crossword. So there are topics about SAP Build and JavaScript and even a reference to Analytics Cloud. And it would help to know something about Sabrina Carpenter.
Can anybody do the crossword?
Yes, definitely. Of course, it helps to know a little bit about SAP. There are 33 questions, fairly easy. A few tougher ones, but I think everybody can do it, and it might even be worth a couple thousand points. And it's already published, so even before Devtoberfest starts, you can accumulate points. So that's pretty good.
That's good to know.
Yeah. Good luck to everybody.
Hello, everybody. We all know the importance of having development, test, and productive environments during the application development. SAP has recently introduced project versioning for SAP Build Apps, web and mobile projects. This allows you to transport the released project versions between development, testing and productive subaccounts on SAP BTP. A transport setup of Cloud Transport Management Service, CTMS, Content Agent Service, CAS and BTP destinations are required to start transporting SAP Build Apps projects between the three-tier dev test prod landscapes. There are four types of subaccounts or tenants involved in the scenario. A source subaccount, this is where the actual development takes place. A target, Under this, we have two sub-accounts, testing and production, and a central sub-account to administer the content transport between the source and target sub-accounts. In order to enable the transport, you will have to enable the Cloud Foundry, subscribe to SAP Build Apps and Content Agent Services, create an instance of Content Agent, and generate a service key on the source and target sub-accounts. On the central sub-account, you need to subscribe to Cloud Transport Management Service, create an instance of Cloud Transport Management, and generate a service key. Various role collection has to be enabled in BTP cockpit to authorize the users for performing the transport activities. SAP Build Lobby configuration has to be done in the control tower in order to set the sub-account type to decide if it's a dev, test, or prod sub-account. Then BTP destinations has to be set from source to central sub-account and then from central to target, that is the test and prod sub-accounts. Finally, set up the transport landscape using the Cloud Transport Management user interface. For more details on this topic, do refer to this interesting blog post by SAP Build expert Mari Hiri. Link is provided in the description box. Enjoy learning and thank you.